Hello everyone. Hi friend. Welcome back to my channel. My name is Mercy and I'm the queen of positivity. Assurance covers you that this recipe is going to work for you. This bath is liberation bath. You take this bath to deliver yourself from every spiritual man attack. One of the signs of negative energies is when you are in Lagos, you are dreaming about your father's house. Is at night you cannot sleep, you're always having sex in the dream, you're always eating in the dreams. Those are signs of bad energies inside you. Bad energies inside you. The spiritual man is inside you. At night he will come out and mess you up. He will even beat you and sleep with you. When he leaves you, because of those things he has deposited in you, you see yourself in your father's house, set back. He will draw you back to your father's house. The idol of your father's house is calling your name. They've used it to sacrifice to the idol. Alright. Whenever you dream, see yourself in your father's house. Tell yourself, I'm already in Lagos. I've pulled off that garment. I cannot go to my father's house. I go for visits. I don't live there. But I will teach you some of your glory is still there in your father's house. That is why the Spirit of God is still drawing you back so that you take that glory along with you to Lagos. Maybe somebody has snatched your glory and they buried it in your father's house. When you are in Lagos, you will still be dreaming about your father's house because your glory is there. So don't always cancel it. If you have not taken your glory with you to that place you are going to, that country you are, you will stay there 20 years, nothing to show for it. Your glory is in your father's house. So you have to recover your glory so that any country you see yourself, you'll be able to possess that land. You'll be able to possess that land for good, for victory, for success, for blessing. Okay? Now this part is going to liberate you. It's going to ward off every negative forces following you, inside you, sleeping when you are sleeping, walking when you are walking, eating when you are eating, running when you are running, even running faster than you, changing your face. Whenever blessing is about to come, whenever you are about to attract a good man, attract a good connection, a good vibration into your life, the Spirit will change your face because it's inside you. They see far. They have four eyes. You have third eye. They have four. They have, in fact, the four eyes is small. They have, is it seven eyes? They have this one you have. They have eye at the middle, center head. They have eye at the back of their head here. So even when you think that they turn their back, their eye here is working two forces. They have eye at their neck, on their neck here. They have eye on their neck. They have eye on their chest. All of them are okay. They have eyes here, they have eyes here. They have eyes all over them. Okay. So, don't think that you face front at the back. They are still monitoring you at the back. They are watching you. Whenever good things are about to come, they come. What did they do? They torment you. Every day, they torment you. You are their slave. You are in their cage. You are in their cage. They see you as a captive. They will hold you captive. All right? Yes. To ensure that you never see good things. What you are seeing around you, what you are touching, is just like chicken change. Chicken change. If God show you who you really are, you will see that there are more. There are more to achieve than you thought that you have arrived. Wealth is from leg. Your wealth is from your leg. How far can your leg take you? It's how far your wealth you can go in terms of living a wealthy life. When you say you are wealthy, you can be wealthy in grace. You are wealthy in grace. Anywhere you go, grace covers you. Grace speaks for you. Grace manifests. can be wealthy in favor wherever you go. Favor. When they say the people that come late, people that did not come, they will deduct their salary. When you did not come, they will pay you your salary. It's not they forget. Grace is speaking. Favor is speaking because you are rich. You are wealthy in favor. Some of you are wealthy in anointing. When they say you are wealthy in anointing, it's that anything you lay your hand, it prosper. Anything you lay your hand, prosper. You want to sell this way, it will move. You want to sell this one, it will move. That's why you see some people are multi-tax. They are doing different businesses and this woman is growing. It must not be much, but it's growing. All right? Another thing, you can also be wealthy in physical cash. Physical cash, you are wealthy. When they say you are wealthy in physical cash, is that you make a business, you get a profit, you use the profit for your own good. Not to do a business, you make profit of 10 million, problem of 20 million will come to take it. You're always doing business, always making profit, but you are in debt. You are not wealthy in wealth. You are wealthy in wealth. When you are able to make physical cash, make your profit from the physical cash or business or your salary, utilize it, use it, have savings, then you are wealthy. It shocked you. It shocked me too. You can be wealthy in power. You are wealthy in power. You have natural back to sender. I know of somebody that has natural back to sender. If you are planning evil for that person, you're wasting your time. Because no arrow that you throw that will succeed. Anything you do, it's just like this. They don't pray the way you pray. They are not really devoted to whatever religion they believe. They are moving forward. They are progressing. Okay? They are living large. They are happy. It's like they have everything. Because they are wealthy in power. But these days, everybody wants to reach. They are wealthy rich. They are wealthy rich. Some people are wealthy in the spiritual realm. Physically, they may not have anything, but spiritually, they are wealthy. When you talk about grace, they have it. Anointing, they have it. Favor, they have it. Power, they have it. Light, they have it. When they are coming like this, when you are seeing them, you'll be seeing glory of God all over them. God on his own is making them famous. God on his own is advertising them. He's the one advertising them. The way they stay is where the blessing come and meet them. Whatever they eat comes to them where they are staying. People want to be their friend. They want to touch them. They want to hold, mommy, auntie, They are spiritually wealthy and they have a lot in them to give, to dish out to the world. All right, I want to stop here. Now, this bath is going to remove all the bad energies in you, the blocking, the headache, the battery, the sex in the dream, the eating in the dream, the witchcraft attack, the moving objects in the dream. In your body, you will remove it. And there will be a restoration of peace, harmony, joy, progress into your life. What do you need to take this path with? Number one is your scent leaf. Number two is your garlic. Number three is your salt. Do you have sea salt? Perfect. You don't have sea salt? Perfect. If you need sea salt, please come and buy me. I still have left for sale. Yes, I have sea salt for sale. If you need to come and buy. All right. Now, the last one that you need is your oil. Extra virgin oil. You can use your mustard seed oil. You can use your almond oil. You can use your extra virgin goya oil. Wellly blessed and fortified. You can check on the channel how to bless your oil. You All right? Yes. Now, whenever you, whatever you call this thing to be, it becomes that thing for you. Okay? So you boil your garlic. Boil your garlic 10 minutes so that the water in your garlic will come out more. Now, I usually start boiling these things when I put my pot to boil. Allow the water to boil. Okay, then transfer your garlic. Peel off the garlic. How many quantity? Now you know, it's your choice. Peel off the back of the garlic. Put it in your boiling water. Let it boil for about 5 to 10 minutes. As it's boiling, you are talking to God. You are talking to the garlic what you want to come out of your body. Is this spiritual man or whatsoever? Moving on, you talk to the garlic. After that, add your scent leaf. Now, when you are boiling your garlic, if you have sea salt, because sea salt don't easily dissolve, add your sea salt. How many can I add? How? Your hand, 7 pieces, anyhow, just add your sea salt to it. If you are using sea salt, when your garlic has boiled up to 10 minutes, off the heat and add your scent leaf, because I need the aroma of the scent leaf. Scent leaf is very weak. I need that aroma of the scent leaf. So add your scent leaf, stir it together, cover your pot, and make your prayer. After that, turn those mixture into a bucket. If you are using normal salt, once you turn it into a bucket, you take your salt, add your salt to it. Then you're going to recite this Bible passage. Isaiah 49, 24, 25, 26. Inside that, the captive of the mind shall be delivered. So you know what you want to do. That spirit you want it to come out of your body. You are speak to the garlic. Speak to the scent leaf. You're going to speak to the garlic. Speak to the garlic what you want. Okay? You want every curse in your life to be broken. You want to block the... Just speak. Okay? No more witchcraft attack. No more setback. Just speak. Then, take your anointing oil and recite Isaiah 10, verse 27. Isaiah 10, verse 27. That the yoke shall be broken by the power of anointing. You anoint the water one, you anoint the two, you anoint the three. In the name of God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. Inside a bucket of water. Then you start praying. After you've prayed, you tell God, whatever you never plant in my body that was not there when I was created, that you didn't create me with spiritual man or moving object, as I take my bath, let that thing come out. That was not there when you were created, that God should deliver you from this. It's a liberation battle. Then you after you're done praying, now, how do I take my bath with this mixture? Take your normal bath with your soap and water. Then this water, as you are bathing, you are speaking out what you don't want, take the leaves, and leaf, whether it's dry leaf or fresh one, just take it and rub your body with the garlic. Be rubbing it with your body with the garlic. Be rubbing it with your body because you're not going to remain it. Rub it all over with your garlic. With the garlic. Some people ask me, can I match or pan my garlic or grate my garlic? Perfect. You can grate your garlic and boil it. It does not change anything. You rub it all over your body. You speak up from your head down to your body, all over your V-pot, right? Especially those that have stress in the dream. You pray, I divorce you, spiritual man. After you know what to say, you know your own. You are done bathing, then use water and rinse your body. After you rinse it, gather everything, dispose it. All right, tomorrow, how many days will I take this bath? My dear, I would have told you to take this bath for 3 nights. 3 nights, yes. Prepare and finish using. Don't leave it in the following day. And while you are doing this, when you finish rinsing your body, don't towel dry. You are sleeping like that. get 3 loaves of garlic, wrap it in tissue, pray your Psalm 91, put it under your pillow and sleep. Come back and testify with so much smile in your face, because the God that I serve, that I know, is going to do you well. He will do you good after you have done this exercise.